Thank you, President Washington, for that session. Now, we hear that God is here with us today. Amen. Now, before we go to something else, I want to recognize the presence of each and everyone that is here, and I believe that God is going to bless us. Amen. So, I'll start with in our congregation levels. Tujue mwangaku wa kututepelea siku ya leo. Tunasimama, we appreciate them. Amen. Amen. Na natumai mungu wata tumarengi pamoja. So, let's start with P.C.E.A nguo. P.C.E.A nguo, kama kwa kwenu P.C.E.A nguo. Personal ya mungu P.C.E.A nguo. Amen. Let's appreciate them. Amen. Then, P.C.E.A's Laga Church. P.C.E.A's Laga. Let's appreciate them. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. And now the host. P.C.E.A Emmanuel Church. Let's appreciate them. Thank you. Amen. Asanteni sana for the host. Amen. We are so much blessed and humble before you and before God. And we really appreciate it. Amen. Nyasante, nyote pia kwa kukuja. Ah, let's appreciate our evangelist too. Kuna kanisa lingine sijatambua. Kuna yeyote sijataja. Sorry? Amen. So, right now I'm going to welcome the preacher. Amen. I want us to hear the word first, and then we'll go to something else. Amen. So our preacher today is Elder Nomu. He's from P.C.E.A, Nomu. And I want to welcome him so that he can share with us what God has sent him to us today. Amen. So let's appreciate him as he comes.
May be that I may obtain children by her. And Abraham hearkened to them. behold, thou art the child and shall bear a son, and shall call his name Ishmael, because the Lord has dealt thy affliction, have had thy affliction. And he will be a wild man, also a render, and he will be a wild man, his heart will be against every man, and every man's heart against him, and he shall dwell in the presence of all his brethren. Verse 13 and the last one. And she called the name of the Lord that spoke unto her, thou shalt thou God seest me, for he has said, have I also here looked after him that seen me? That's the word of God today. Praise be to God. As I have said, that our faith is waiting upon the Lord. We have heard of two people. Now we have heard of David, and now there's another man of God, a man of faith, that is Abraham. Abraham received a covenant, a promise from God, and God told him, you will be a father of great nation. And he said to that, because whatever God promises, he do fulfill, but in a condition of waiting upon the Lord. Sometimes you may not go a smooth journey as you wait upon God. You may not go up and down, trials and temptations to test your faith, to see whether you still stick to the promise of God, whether you continue waiting upon the Lord. And being told that you be a father of great nation, he was not a young man in his time. He was over 75 years. And down the line, there was no sign of promise. About 10 years, there was no sign of God fulfilling this promise. And this young man, we do give up and ask God, was it really God? Where the devil puts doubts in your heart and says, sure, was it really God? Probably that was not the will of God. And then you started to quit quitting. Have you ever taken any journey of faith in what you knew for sure that it was God who was leading you? But everything seemed clear when you received God's direction, but perhaps you think it would take weeks or months, but it takes years. In the history of Israelites, when they were leaving from Egypt to Canaan, they waited for the promise for 430 years. And in the process of waiting, they complained against God, asked me to go back to Egypt because it was not smooth for them as they waited. So I want to assure you this morning, it will not seem so smooth for your journey, for you in this journey as you wait. But what does the Bible tell us to continue waiting upon God? This morning, could you be like this Abraham, when your faith starts fading because you have waited for a number of years? When you have been seeking for national alternative option rather than supernatural, you know, when you wait and wait and wait, you see there is no sign of God intervening in my situation, we look for the natural way. But the Bible tells us to wait for supernatural, because what God can do when you wait, no man can do it. Praise be to God. What do you do when the season or the timing seems too late? When you ask God to bless, our second option here. You know, when Abraham waited for all those years, when I was telling you to underline is when they waited for the promise, and Sarai was impatient this time, and they wondered, and maybe he asked Abraham, are you still waiting on God? For all those number of years, 10 years, now I'm growing old, now I'm a nature of a grand man, are you still waiting for the promise? Where are you looking for alternative? And that's what we do as natural men. When our promises seem to die, we fail to wait upon God. We look for alternative or second option. And now, as Sarai whispered to Abraham, now we are not going to wait anymore. Now I'm growing old, and now I'm a grandmother, and I have a house, a house of me. Why can't you give God a wife? Can't I give you for you to be a wife so that you can bear children? But remember this, the Bible says, I think that's verse 4, that Abraham hearkened unto the voice of Sarah. But remember, he who God spoke unto Abraham concerning the promise, but not to Sarah. She was called Sarai at that time. But God did not speak to Sarah. spoke to Abraham, he entered into a covenant with him when he told him, "I'll be a father of great nation." I didn't wonder, how can I be a father of great nation?
But you have seen to time. What are you doing? Are you
upon the Lord. Do you know how much my mother is doing? Do you know that? I'm feeling your peace. I'm looking at this man who's got a man of faith, but this time I can see his faith fading. Because you could have asked him, why were you not having a promise from God? But you say it. That's where Abraham said, no, I won't go this way. I won't go to God. She hearkened to the voice of Sarah. There will be very many promises that you see from men as you wait. And they will tell you, you have been waiting for a while. Maybe you have been trusting God for a job. They will tell you, what would you like to do? You may attain that job, yes, but there will be consequences because this is not from God. So Abraham deceived this son, Hagar conceived, and they got a son, but this was not the promised son. Yes, sometimes you have to go to Ishmael as the option. When you turn like God has time, sometimes out of despair, we ask God to bless our second option. Rather than continue believing God for his promise. You know, sometimes you tell God, God bless this, God bless this, God bless this. God intervene in his case. God never intervene in whatever he has not started. We have to go back to the process of waiting and trust God for his leading and direction. It doesn't matter. Then you should have waited upon God. But this morning, I want to encourage you, do not give up on the promises of God. Keep in mind that your Ishmael is not God best for you. Praise be to God. Yes, there will be consequences of having Ishmael as the second option. Have you settled for Ishmael option? Because God promised to you, has taken too long. You know yourself. But this morning, I want to encourage you. You know, Abraham went along with the plan, but when the circumstances started, he started bringing one another. This, it is the servant. It is the house that I gave you has brought all this, rather than focusing unto God. So as I come to the climax, I want to tell you this morning, to encourage you. You have been praying for something. You've been trusting God, and you've been waiting for God for a period, and all you've seen like this period of time has gone too long. I may think of something else. Especially the young people, at times when you wait upon God, you see there's no sign of God coming. You go for any option that is a failure. You will be led by anybody who is available and willing. This morning, I want to encourage you to know that God's time is the best. He's not limited by time. He controls time and season, and he knows the best time for you. Patient. You know, sometimes when we pray and we go before God, God answers our prayers in three ways. He may say yes, and that's why people rejoice and they praise God, they justify, you know, the dreams of the Lord, the great of joy, because of instant miracles. But I want to assure you, not always the miracles are good. Praise be to God. We don't have instant miracles because we don't want to wait. At times God says no to the promise. He says no. When you pray contrary to God's will, he says no. No matter the time you take in waiting and praying and fasting, if you pray contrary to his will, he will say no. The last thing that he answers our prayers is wait. The process of waiting is not easy. And many of us don't like waiting, isn't it? We like instant miracles. But I assure you, when you see a promise of after waiting a duration of time, you have a great testimony. You do say this, I've been waiting upon the Lord from this time to this time, and now God has intervened into my case. Praise be to God. He will never slack to fulfill what he has promised unto you as you wait. So I want to encourage you. Continue waiting upon the Lord. It will not be in vain as you wait. Never make this mistake that Sarah and Abraham made when they received Ishmael. But Ishmael would not inherit. He would not take the possession of Isaac. But God gave Abraham and Isaac at his own as Sarah and Abraham Praise be to God. If you will do it upon God, you expect Ishmael in your life and there will be consequences. May God help us today to continue waiting patiently unto Him. And again, I say again, it will not be in vain. This is a year of waiting upon the leading of God, waiting patiently. And you see, the Lord leading in His direction. Praise be to God. May the Lord God bless you this morning as you continue waiting patiently unto Him. God bless you. God you matters. Amen. God bless. Amen. God bless you so much, Elder. And may He expound your territories. Amen. This time I'm going to ask you.